Hi, my name is Allison Robinson, and I am the speech pathologist at Oklahoma Able Tech. This video is going to give you guidelines and resources for completing assistive technology, or AT, assessments as a team. The video will also provide you a system of checks and balances for your school to determine how its AT process is working. We'll start by quickly defining assistive technology. AT is a device or piece of equipment that is used to increase, maintain, or improve functional capabilities of children with disabilities. AT is also a service that directly assists children with a disability in the selection, acquisition, or use of an AT device. Assessing whether or not a student needs AT would be an AT service. As we explain the AT assessment process, please note that the terms assessment and evaluation may be used interchangeably during this video. Both terms are intended to mean the same thing. Also, we are going to reference the quality indicators for assistive technology, also known as the QUIET, as assessment is the second quality indicator that schools may focus on to determine if their students are receiving quality AT services. Consideration of AT needs is the first quality indicator, and the processes are different. Consideration is a short discussion that may take place during an IEP meeting using information the team already knows about the student, resulting in the decision to continue using AT or to try or not try AT. The assessment process can be a much more lengthy process and is used when the team is looking for new information. If you or your school needs more information regarding the quality indicators for assistive technology, please view Able Tech's YouTube channel and/or visit quiet.org. The goals of this video are to help schools understand the AT assessment process, as well as for them to learn what promising practice is for AT assessment. Promising practice is for districts to have clearly defined procedures that are used by everyone involved in the assessment process. The QUIET self-evaluation matrices can be used to gauge how well a district is doing this. The matrix for AT assessment covers 7 indicators of best practice and ranges from a scale of 1 to 5, with 1 being unacceptable and 5 being promising practice. The matrices can be found at quiet.org as well. Here are some points to keep in mind regarding assessment. Number 1, AT assessments are not completed with the administration of 1 test during a singular event. Instead, they are ongoing and should be a continual part of the student's educational planning. Number 2, AT assessments are conducted in the student's customary educational setting by a multidisciplinary team, with at least 1 member being knowledgeable about AT. The assessment process has many steps, and we will be discussing each one. From forming a team, to gathering and reviewing information on the student, environments, and tasks, to trialing potential AT devices and collecting data on the trials, to making a decision, providing needed AT, documenting it in the IEP, and implementing its use in the student's customary environments. First things first, a team of people is needed to participate in the assessment process, and these may or may not be the same members as the IEP team. Each member should be able to share information about the student, educational environments, and tasks that the student will be asked to complete or participate in. As we just mentioned, the team should be multidisciplinary, and at least 1 person should have a knowledge about AT. This team will be charged with observing the student in his or her natural settings during various activities, interacting with the student to create opportunities for the student to try AT, interviewing the student, family, and/or school personnel, reviewing records, and any other activity that results in gained information. Teams may use Joy Zabala's SET framework to explore and record information about the student, environments, and tasks. The framework can be found at joyzabala.com. promising practice is for flexible teams to be formed based on the knowledge of the individual student's needs, environments, and their tasks, who with an expertise in AT consistently conduct assessments. Based on information gathered about the student, environments, and tasks, the team will create a list of assistive technology features that the student may need to progress in those educational settings. Examples of AT features possibly needed for writing may be word prediction, dictation, graphic organizers, etc. The team will then need to brainstorm specific AT tools or devices that have these features and may need to be trialed with the student. Promising practice is for functional components of AT assessment to be consistently conducted in the student's customary environment. Once a list of potential AT tools and devices is created, the team needs to identify who is going to coordinate the AT device trials and training for the student and applicable team members for how to use the AT. Identify a start and finish date for the trial, criteria for determining if the trial was successful, and have a process for collecting and reviewing trial data with the IEP team. In Oklahoma, there are great options for completing device trials. The local education agency or school may have AT in their inventory. Schools may also contact specific vendors for items. Also, the AIM Center at the Oklahoma Library for the Blind and Oklahoma Able Tech have devices for trial purposes. Contact the AIM Center at www.library.state.ok.us/AIM and Oklahoma Able Tech at ok.gov/AbleTech. Promising practice is for AT assessments to be conducted in a timely manner and include a plan for ongoing assessment and trials in customary environments. Your school may also need assistance with collecting trial data and making a decision about specific AT. Visit joyzabala.com for guiding forms, as well as www.wati.org for the Wisconsin Assistive Technology Initiative Technology Trial Use Guide. Promising practice is for recommendations to be consistently based on data about student performance on typical tasks in customary environments. The next step is providing the AT and documenting in the IEP. The LEA is responsible for making sure the needed AT is provided at no cost to the student and family. This does not necessarily mean the school has to pay for the items. Depending on the type of AT required, there are many funding sources available to the student, including Medicaid, also known as Sooner Care in Oklahoma, the Oklahoma Durable Medical Equipment Reuse Program, private insurance, and additional private sources. The parents or guardians may also decide to purchase the AT for their child. You can view funding sources specific to Oklahoma in AbleTech's Funding for AT manual, found at ok.gov/AbleTech. To obtain a device for the student, the team needs to identify the source of equipment and costs, identify possible funding sources like we mentioned earlier, order the equipment, plan for training on how to use the equipment as needed, set up equipment when it arrives, and establish a technical support team. The equipment will need to be maintained by the LEA, and roles and responsibilities should be determined prior to receiving the equipment so that it can be implemented into the student's educational environment in a timely fashion. Details of the needed AT should be included in the IEP, and there are three areas where this may be done: special education, related services, and/or supplementary aids and services. Please see the Assistive Technology Technical Assistance document for the state of Oklahoma for specific examples on including AT in the IEP. This can be viewed on AbleTech's website or at the Oklahoma State Department of Education's website. Promising practice is for documented recommendations to consistently include sufficient information about devices and services to guide decision-making and program development. When implementing assistive technology into the environments that the student is required to perform, schools should plan where technology should be located, used, and maintained. Those who will be using the technology should be properly trained on using it, and contingency plans should be in place to ensure that the student has access to the AT tool or system in the event that the primary AT malfunctions. The team should continue to monitor student performance and use of AT while it is being implemented. See the AT-TA document for additional resources on implementation as well. AT in the school setting is a process and can be started at any point on the student's educational path. Promising practice is when AT use is frequently monitored and AT needs are generally reassessed if current tools and strategies are ineffective. Reassessment generally includes ongoing assessment strategies and includes formal assessment if indicated. We hope that you have found the information in this video to be understandable and applicable. If you need help at any point in the assessment process, feel free to contact Oklahoma Able Tech for guidance and support. We look forward to helping you whenever you need us.